I'm not from a musical family, but I have music around quite a lot in the house. And my dad's a massive music fan, so I was brought up with really good music. And there was a piano in the house, which he inherited from his mum, so that was in the house, and I just sort of gravitated towards that when, like, from a really young age. Someone came to me with the idea of a pop-up book, and that was completely along the lines of what I wanted, because before it was mentioned, I imagined having almost an animated theme, and I didn't really want myself to be focus of the video. I thought I'd like to do something quite creative. For my album, I think writing each song was a process individually, so there wasn't a collective concept for my album. Like, obviously it's not a concept album, but like, I think as a group of songs, they flow nicely, and all of the songs I've written over the last 2 years, I think, of my life, and they weren't like sort of building up to be an album, because obviously I didn't know that was going to happen to me. I thought, you know, it was great. So a lot of them I already had, and most of them I like just sort of either pulled out and rewrote. But then a few of them I've written like quite recently, and they've become ones that have been on the album. I've worked with Goldie, and that was a really great experience. He's like a creative machine. Like his ideas seem to be, he seems to have the same enthusiasm as he must have had when he was like my age, because he's really, really energetic and really lively and really like just so into what he's doing, and he really values everything about music, which for me is like completely someone that I'd look like working with, someone totally passionate about getting a feeling and capturing a feeling instead of being involved with worrying about selling a record or whatever.
Storm is threatening my very life today.
There's loads of amazing singers around, and like it's quite refreshing to have, like, after Amy Winehouse, because it's almost like she's left something behind for everyone to follow. But in like being compared, I don't mind it. I think it's quite flattering, but I do think that everyone, like every one of the female artists is definitely individual. Like, I think the thing in common with, like, say, like Adele and Jessie J, they both have great voices, but I don't think there's much similarity between them musically. I think, and I see myself that way as well, because I think if you listen to my album, there's quite a lot of lyrics and there's quite a lot of content in there, which isn't just about me doing vocal acrobatics.
My book on lost its way.
I'd like there to be a way that I'd like to come across, but I think I'll grow with that within time. Like, once I'm more used to doing gigs and I think people are more receptive to what I'm singing and stuff, like, I'll gain more confidence with, I'd like to think that maybe someone would leave the gig and think, like, remember it or whatever. And I hope that's the case now, but I think for me at the moment, it's just, as long as my thought is, if I'm enjoying the music, which I normally am, then most people are, and like, I know that if I'm singing the best I can sing, most people will clock on to that. So that's kind of, I'd like people to leave a gig thinking they've seen some good music.
It's just a shadow way, it's just a shadow way, rainbow, it's just a shadow.